everybody, AFN's playing.
The essence of life and health. During the 1960s, then Air Force Lieutenant Colonel Dr. Kenneth Cooper developed the concept of aerobic fitness using research collected at Lackland Air Force Base, Texas. Cooper now heads the Institute for Aerobics Research in Dallas, Texas, and travels worldwide promoting aerobics and healthier living.
I have a presentation I entitled, Can You Afford Not to Exercise? Our studies indicate that ideally, if you begin exercising regularly during your youth, you'll get long-term benefits from it. But you can't store it. And what you do today is what's important. It's not what you did 6 years ago. We've also been impressed to see what older people can do. We're beginning to rewrite the textbooks on aging because we're finding people in advanced years are achieving extremely high levels of fitness. Our concepts of aging are changing. And I'm convinced if you want to slow down aging, forget about cardiovascular fitness and heart attacks for a moment, but if you want to slow down aging, three things in this order must be eliminated. And number one is cigarette smoking. Number two is inactivity. And number three is obesity. And then once you eliminate those things, only can you slow down aging, you can prolong life. Exercise can be used in three general ways. It can be used for rest and relaxation. It can be used for muscle building and figure contouring. It can be used for cardiovascular pulmonary conditioning. Now, all three have merit, but only one has the potential of prolonging your life. That's number three, cardiovascular pulmonary conditioning. One of the beauties of the aerobics program is that you can vary your exercises. You don't have to do the same thing every day. In fact, I have people who will play racquetball one day, swim another day, run the next day. But those people who are physically fit aerobically, they are less depressed, they are less of a hypochondriac, they improve their self-image, have a much more positive attitude towards life. If you're past 40 years of age, you certainly should progress slowly and ideally check with your physician and have some type of an evaluation of your heart, at least a resting EKG and preferably some type of stress electrocardiogram. More recent studies have indicated that just avoiding inactivity is the most important thing. So if you just take the stairs other than the escalator, if you walk to the store rather than driving the car, if you play golf, dance, bowl, anything that has merit, if you want to exercise, you can find an exercise in which you can participate and enjoy it. Err to the side of conservatism and go slowly at the program. Walk before you run. It may have taken you 15 years to get out of condition. It's going to take you longer than 15 days to get back into condition. So that's the thing I try to motivate people to do. Get started, slowly, progressively into the program. Don't push yourself. Listen to your body. Those are all the basic recommendations that I give. But then in conjunction with that, I challenge you with this question. Don't you feel better? Doesn't it enhance your sense of well-being? Exercising regularly makes us feel better. It's the quality of life that we enjoy because we're physically fit that motivates us to continue exercising. And finally, can you afford not to exercise?